So, after the mathemes of the previous video, perhaps it would be useful to summarise where we've got to. So Laplanche has, in effect, rescued two of Freud's early ideas from oblivion. And we'll come back to what this oblivion consists of shortly. The first idea that's been rescued is that repression is a failure of translation. This is what we saw in the last video. And the second, which we saw earlier on, is Freud's idea about the primacy of seduction. And I say Freud's idea because Freud never quite turned it into a theory. The British psychoanalyst Donald Winnicott famously said that there's no such thing as a baby. Well, likewise, Laplanche starts with the adult subject who offers something to the child. This adult offers food, warmth, safety, shelter. But she also offers something else, something enigmatic, beyond the grasp of the child and indeed beyond the grasp of herself. The child tries to translate or make sense of this something else, and it partially succeeds. The message can indeed be partially understood. In fact, to all intents and purposes, it seems to be entirely understood, from the perspective of the ego at least. But there's also that something that fails to be translated, fails to be integrated or metabolized, something that remains foreign. An irritative thorn, in the words of Dominique Scarfone, who has written extensively on Laplanche. And this foreign body, this thorn, this remainder, is the repressed. Or perhaps better, repression is this failure of translation, this failure to completely absorb what's been implanted through the adult's message. So on the one hand, on the one side, we have integration, translation, binding, the ego, the conscious, and on the other side, the foreign body, the irritative thorn, the failure of translation, the unbound, the source of the drive, and the repressed sexual unconscious. In the words of Dominique Scarfone, an analyst who has, as I say, written on Laplanche, there's an essay that you can find on PepWeb and probably other places, which I think is just called Laplanche. He says, the unconscious, therefore, is to be understood in a systemic sense. That's to say, as made up of those inassimilable remnants, the residues of the failed translation of the other's message. Such a process of implantation is what Laplanche refers to as general seduction, the inevitable result of the adult-infant interaction. Now note here that contrary to the Ptolemaic tendencies of Freud and his successors, there's no inbuilt unconscious. The unconscious, and by extension that means human sexuality, infant sexuality, is not there from the start. It's not prehistoric or biological or inherited. It's a result of the interaction with the other, and specifically the adult other. So what's the point of all this? It makes for a plausible theory, perhaps, but what bearing does it have on psychoanalytic practice? This is a huge question, but one way of thinking about it is that psychoanalysis itself, the psychoanalytic encounter itself, replicates in a very uncanny way this fundamental situation in infancy. In other words, every psychoanalysis is a seduction. And in the penultimate video, the next one, I'll say something about how Laplanche views transference through this prism of seduction.